Unix cron expressions are at the heart of every cron job running on computer systems all across the world. These cron expressions are how you tell computers exactly when to run your jobs. So in this video, I'm going to teach you everything you need to know about cron expressions so that you can write your own and read the expressions written by others. Kubernetes, CI/CD tools like Argo, cloud-based schedulers like AWS EventBridge, workflow runners like Apache Airflow, and even automation tools like Jira. Every system that allows you to schedule tasks expects you to know cron expressions. So if you're an engineer or anybody who automates stuff, this is a fundamental concept you need to know. Let's get started. A cron expression is a string comprising five fields separated by spaces. Each field represents a specific unit of time, and these fields are evaluated to determine when a scheduled task should run. From left to right, these fields are minute, hour, day of the month, and day of the week. Each field is mandatory, so you need to add a value for it. Every cron execution system expects your expression to have these five fields. Of course, sometimes you don't want to specify certain fields. For example, you want your cron to run every day, not just on one particular day. So you don't want to specify a value for the day. I will also show you what to do in those scenarios. Cool, let's break down each of these fields now. The first field is minute. It can take any value from 0 to 59. 0 here means the start of the hour. So if, for example, you specify 0 for minute and you specify 8 for hour, that makes it 8 a.m., right? But at the same time, if you specify 25 for minute and you specify 8 for hour, it becomes 8:25 a.m. The second field is hour, which takes values from 0 to 23. Here, 0 means the start of the day, which is 12 a.m., right? And 23 means 11 p.m. So the moment you reach 11:59, after that, it goes back to hour 0 the next day. So for example, if you specify 15 as minutes and 0 as hours, this translates to 12:15 a.m., right? Pretty much the start of the day, 15 minutes into the day. But if you specify 15 in minutes and 12 in hours, that means 12:15 p.m. But let's say if you specify 15 for minutes and 23 for hour, that translates to 11:15 p.m., almost end of the day. Another example, if let's say you specify 30 for minutes and 14 for hour, that translates to 2:30 p.m. The third field is day of the month. This is ranging from 1 to 31, where 1 means the start of the month, the first of the month, and 31 means 31st of the month, which is the last day of any month possible. A value of 15 would mean that the job runs on 15th of the month, right? But obviously, depending on the month, some of the values might be invalid. For example, if you specify the month as February, then 30 and 31 are not valid values for that month. The fourth field is the month. The month ranges from 1 to 12, where 1 means January and 12 means December. Some systems also allow you to use abbreviations for it. For example, for January, you can specify JAN, and for February, FEB, and so on. So if, for example, you specify a value of 7, then that translates to the job would run in the 7th month, which is July. So the job would run in the month of July. The last field is day of the week, which lets you specify the day of the week. This ranges from 0 to 6, where 0 is Sunday, 1 is Monday, 2 is Tuesday, and so on, until 6, 6 is Saturday. Systems that support abbreviations also support them for the day of the week. So for example, for Sunday, you could write SUN, for Monday, you could write MON, etc. So if, for example, I specify a value of 3 for day of the week, it will execute on the fourth day, because it starts at 0. So that means at Wednesday. If I specify 3, the job will run on Wednesday. Note that some cron execution systems which provide more precision also support a sixth field called seconds to specify the precise second at which the job must be executed. For example, HashiCorp's Nomad supports a second field and even a year field. Similarly, AWS EventBridge also allows us to specify year. These are not part of the Unix cron expression standard, but many modern systems provide them to allow for more flexibility. Now, before we move on to full examples, you need to also be aware of special characters in crons. Remember when I asked you what you would do if you didn't want to specify a particular value for a field? Special characters is the answer. And like the name suggests, these characters allow for special behavior, which is often needed for more complex schedules. An asterisk matches any value. So if I wanted to run my cron every day, I wouldn't specify any value for day of the month. Instead, I would specify an asterisk for it. This would mean cover all the days of the month from 1 to 31 or to whichever day applicable in that month. So use asterisk when you want to cover all the values in a particular field. Then a comma allows you to specify multiple values for a field. So for example, if you wanted your cron to run on Saturdays and Sundays, right, you would specify 6,0 for your day of the week. This runs your task on just Saturday and Sunday and not the other days of the week. Then comes the hyphen. A hyphen defines a range of values. Let's say you want your cron to run only during the first half of the year, which means from January till June. So for this, in the month field, you can specify 1 to 6. This specifies the range of January to June for the month. You could also use comma and write 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but you see how quickly this can get impractical, right? So you use range instead. Finally, there's the slash. A slash represents increments. Let's say I want to run my cron every 10 minutes, right? I specify something like this for the minute field, which says 0, which means start my cron at the 0th minute, which is the first minute of the hour, right? Right at the start of the hour. And slash 10, which means run this cron every 10 minutes, at the increment of every 10 minutes. If instead of 0, I wrote 5, and if my field said 5/10, that would mean run this job every 10 minutes, starting at the 5th minute of the hour, right? So at minute 5, then minute 15, then minute 25, and so on. Awesome. Now that you understand all the rules of Unix cron expressions, let's go and check out some examples. Run a cron job every day at 5 p.m. Okay. This means I can leave all the other fields as asterisk. I mainly am concerned about the minute and the hour field, right? 5 p.m. means minute would be 0 and hour would be 5, right? So let's write 0, 5, star. Okay. Everything else is just asterisk. One more thing. It's not going to be 5 over here because 5 means 5 p.m. Instead, I should be writing 17. So this is 5 p.m. every day. Very easy. Let's go to something more complex. Run a cron job every Monday at 8 a.m. Okay. So we know that for minute and hour, it's simple. 8 a.m. means minute is 0 and hour is 8. It's a.m. So hour is indeed 8. Cool. We know this, right? Every Monday. Now, that means I have nothing to do with day of the month and then month. So they can just be asterisk. And I'm mainly concerned about day of the week, which is Monday. Sunday is 0, Monday is 1. So 1. So this is going to be our expression. Oh, by the way, there are also plenty of free tools available online that will help you create new cron expressions or interpret your cron expressions. So we can actually use one of those to just verify our cron expressions. Let's start here. I'm just going to use crontab guru, but like, yeah, there are plenty of other options out there. Okay. Let's go run a cron every day. So our expression was 0/17 **. 0/17 at 5 p.m. Yes. Perfect. It was correct. Next, run a cron every Monday at 8 a.m. 0/8**1. Let's see. 0/8*1. Yes, perfect. 8 a.m. every Monday. So that's also correct. Let's go on to the next example. Run a cron every 15 minutes. Okay. Every 15 minutes, which means there is a increment of 15 minutes, which means I need to use a slash, right? Since the increment is in minutes, I need to use slash in the minutes field. So what I can do is */15, and since there's no other details, everything else is just **. I know it's asterisk, but it's just too annoying to call it asterisk all the time, so I go with **. So let's see if that's correct. *15. every 15th minute.
Yep, it's correct.
Okay, then let's move on to the next one. Run a cron job at midnight on the 1st of every month.
Ooh, okay.
Cool. Midnight means start of the new day, which is 12 a.m., right? So 00 for minute, zero, I mean. Then 12 for, yeah, okay, but this 12 signifies 12 p.m. So instead, what I want to do is zero for hour, which is midnight, on the 1st of every month, right? So day of the month is one, because 1st of every month. Since we are running it every month, there is no specific month, so I supply the asterisk for month. Okay, and finally, day of the week doesn't matter here. So this is going to be my expression, 001 star star. Let's verify that. At midnight on the 1st of every month.
Perfect.
Okay. Then run a cron job every weekday at 3 p.m. Okay. So once again, first of all, it's 3 p.m. So minute would be 0 and hour would be 3. No, that's 3 a.m. It would be 15 for 3 p.m. Okay. Every weekday, which means nothing to do with day of the month. I just supply asterisk. Nothing to do with month itself, also asterisk. Every weekday, that means Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, right? Sunday is 0, so Monday is 1. And Tuesday, so I could do something like comma 2, comma 3, comma 4, comma 5 like this, but it's just too annoying, right? So instead, I could specify a range here. 6 is Saturday, so 5 is Friday, means 1 to 5. And that's going to be our cron, right? 015 star star 1 to 5. Let's see if this works. 015 star star 1 to 5. 3 p.m. every day of the week from Monday through Friday.
Perfect.
Yeah, okay. So we got a cron job for every weekday, 3 p.m. Up next, we've got run a cron job at 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. on weekends. Okay, interesting. So we know that for both of these, the minute is 0. So minute remains 0. Now 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. right? 6 a.m. is simple. 6 p.m. would be 18, right? So comma 18. So I give 6 comma 18 so that these are the 2 hours that we are interested in on weekends. So day of the month does not mean anything here. Asterisk month does not mean anything here. Weekends, Saturday and Sunday, which means Saturday is 6 and Sunday is 0. So 6 comma 0. So this should be our expression. Let's check it out. 0, 6, 18, star, star, 6, 0. 0, 6, 18, star, star, and then 6, 0. A minute 0 past hour 6 and 18. Yes, on Saturdays and Sundays. Perfect. So 6 a.m. and 6 p.m. on Saturdays and Sundays is when our cron will run. So you can see even very complex schedules can be taken care of with cron expressions. That's how flexible they are. Now let's do an Uno reversal. Let's try to decode some expressions, decode some cron expressions to understand what exactly they do. And then we'll verify whether we are right or wrong. Okay. So 37 star star. Okay. So minute is 30, hour is 7. So 7:30 a.m. Okay. Something happens at 7:30 a.m. Day of the month and month are star. Okay. 1 to 5, that's Monday to Friday. So this cron will run at 7:30 a.m. Monday to Friday on weekdays, right? So let's verify that. 37 star star 1 to 5. 37 star star 1 to 5. 7:30 every day of the week, Monday to Friday. Perfect. Cool. Let's go on to the next one. 001 star slash 2 star. Okay, so 0 minute and 0 hour, that's 12 a.m. Start of the day, midnight. Okay, 12 a.m. first of the month. Now for month we specify star, which means every month, but slash 2, which means increments of 2, so every 2 months, right? And then nothing for just every weekday, so it doesn't matter, which means this cron will run midnight on the first of the month, every 2 months, starting at the first month, which is January, right? Note one thing, when we specify something like this, a star, right? By it, the default value that the cron expression will always pick up is the first month, right? So unless you specify some other value, it's going to be the first of the month. So which means this cron will run midnight on 1st of January, then midnight on 1st of March, then midnight 1st of May, and so on, right? January, March, May, and so on. If, for example, we were to specify 2 over here, right? Then the first run of the cron would be on February, because 2 is month February. And then it would be like midnight of 1st of February, then April, then June, and so on. We can try that out. 001 star slash 2 star 001 star slash 2. And what was it then? Stars. So at midnight on 1st of the month, every 2 months. Correct. That's perfect. And we should also just confirm the other thing. Instead of star, let's say I specify month 2, right? From February through December. That's the difference. Okay. So if you put star, it picks up the first of the month. Like, it picks up the first value as the default value. If I specify 1, which is the same thing as star, and the difference starts to happen when I supply some other value, like 3, 4, then it determines from when to when the cron should run. Cool. Then let's go to the next one. 15, 14, 1, star 0. Okay. So 15 is minutes. So, and 14 means 2 p.m. So 2:15 p.m. First of the month. Yeah. First of the month. Then for month itself is star, which means every month. And 0 for day of the week, which means 0 is Sunday, right? So this cron would run at 2:15 p.m. This is an interesting case, and pay attention here. So what's happening is this cron would run at 2:15 p.m. on 1st of every month, right? Every month, 1st. And it would also run on all Sundays. That's the important part here. So there are two different scenarios in which this cron would run, right? It would run both during first of the month, every month, and then also Sundays. Now, I have an interesting question for you. What happens if there is one first of the month, which is also a Sunday? Does this cron run only once, or does it run twice? Because it should be running on both first of the month and on Sunday at 2:15 p.m. But if both of them fall on the same day, then what should happen? Tell me your answer in the comments below. Now, when you're working with cron expressions, you can use plenty of tools freely available online to make your life easier. I use CronTab Guru, but you can find many other tools. Even the free version of ChatGPT is super accurate, and it can help you both create cron expressions and understand the meaning of those written by others. Seriously, guys, start using AI in your daily life. I'm thinking of creating a dedicated video on using AI for DevOps engineers. And here is your challenge for today. Figure out the meaning of these cron expressions and tell me your answers in the comments. I will also put these expressions in the comments below. Don't cheat. One very important note before I leave you. Never assume the time zone of your cron system. Always clarify it. Let's say you deployed a cron job that runs at 2 p.m. every day. And you deployed this cron job in a Kubernetes cluster running in India. Now, if you deploy that same cron expression in a Kubernetes cluster running in California, that cron will be running at 2 p.m. California time, and not 2 p.m. India time. Similarly, let's say once again you deployed the cron for 2 p.m. every day in India, but the time zone of that Kubernetes cluster is set to UTC. Once again, that cron is not actually going to be running at 2 p.m. IST, but rather it's going to be running at 2 p.m. UTC. I hope my video was useful to you. If you like it, show me that you like it. Just press the like button on the video. Share it with your other engineer friends who want to get their stuff done on time, pun intended. I will see you next time.